Now that we're at the end of the year, there's a lot that we can look back on. The end of the year is a perfect time for reflection on what worked and what didn't work in your life. But don't worry, we're going to keep our focus on baseball today. Reflection on your year of baseball is a critical piece for preparing for the next year. And that's exactly what we're diving into today. The start of the new year is also the start of off-season workouts for baseball. And in today's Bullpen Bulletin, I'm giving you my top things to focus on this off-season for your workouts. This video is not only perfect for coaches who are starting their off-season workouts with their team, but also for players who are looking to improve their own skills this off-season. Hey team, Coach Hart here with Building Better Baseball, the best place for baseball education. If you're just finding this channel and we've never met, I'm so glad you're here. Welcome to the team. If you're a youth baseball player or a coach and you'd like to improve your game, then look no further. Hit that subscribe button and the notification bell, because I'm here every week with a brand new video to help you level up your game. If you stay until the end of the video, I'm giving away a couple free guides as my gift to you for stopping by. Now, let's make the most of your off-season workouts. The number one thing you should work on is conditioning and strength building. The number one thing that you should focus on in your off-season workouts is conditioning and building strength. This is your prime time to build strength and condition your body. You can afford to handle all the things that come with strength and conditioning, like the next day soreness, the extra time that it takes out of practice, the extra energy it takes during practice. And obviously, we always pray that injuries don't happen, but if you happen to have an injury, you have time before the season starts to heal your body. The next three things on the list are all things that you can do also in the baseball season. But going through an entire strength and conditioning program can only happen in the off season. Now, don't mishear me. I'm not saying that you can't do any type of conditioning during the season, but anything you do during the season will be to maintain what you built in the off season. The off-season is for gaining muscle and gaining better fitness. When you're in season, that's for maintenance. My video, The Two Best Ways the Youth Players Can Build Strength, is a deep dive on building strength for youth players. If you'd like to learn more about this topic, I've linked that video in the description below. I know that when I conducted my off-season workouts for my team, each practice session was about an hour and a half. I always used the first half hour of practice for a team workout, and then the final hour was baseball related. I always started the practice with the workout because it was the most important thing to get done, and my team needed to get used to playing when they were tired. So the last hour of practice, they would be fielding, hitting, and pitching after just completing a full workout. That's exactly how they're going to feel when they play in the last inning with the game on the line. The second thing you should work on are basic mechanics. Off-season workouts is a perfect time for a total reset and refresher on all basic mechanics. During the season, you spend a lot of time on team-oriented skills like fielding ground balls or fly balls with your unit, taking batting practice on the field, or team plays like first and third or bunt plays, things like that. Unless you're in a warm climate where you can be outside all year round, most teams are stuck inside of a gym or an indoor baseball facility for their off-season workouts. This is the perfect time to work on the little things. It's a perfect time to break out all the cool devices and pieces of equipment for all sorts of different drills. Coaches probably don't want to carry all this extra stuff around during the season, so break it out in the off-season to work on basic mechanics. Going back to the basics and working on the little things in the off-season allows you time to focus on the things that are not necessarily hurting your performance, but if they were fixed, you would become a more complete player. One example is your throwing arm slot as a player. Does your ball tail to your arm side when you throw it? That's because your arm slot is more of a three-quarters or a side arm slot rather than throwing over the top. If you throw over the top, your ball won't move nearly as much when you throw it. This little tweak is an example of something that's not really hurting your performance. You can still throw the ball just fine. But if it were fixed, you'd have a lower number of bad throws to first base. This is exactly what off-season workouts are for, to break down your game into the little things so you can come out during the season a more complete player. The third thing you should focus on are position skill work and drills. The third thing you want to focus on is individual position skill work. When you're in the season, there's never any time for first basemen to only work on things that first basemen do, like properly setting up at the bag to take a throw. They usually get lumped in with the infielders group just like any other position. The offseason is the time for each position on the field to practice specific position skill work. Pitchers should be working on pitching mechanics, arm strength, pickoff moves, and covering first base on right side ground balls. Catchers should be working on blocking, receiving, framing, and proper footwork to catch foul balls behind the plate. First basemen should be working on their individual skills. Same thing goes with second basemen, shortstops, and third basemen. There are even things that you can do for each outfield position. There's something that makes each position on the field different from all the other eight positions, and whatever that uniqueness is needs to be practiced in the offseason. The fourth one is for coaches, and that's team building. This last one is for coaches. It's important to do some team building activities with your team in the offseason. Usually, offseason practices are split up by positions and groups where it's possible for two teammates to not interact at all the whole practice. You don't want that to be a regular thing where you go through an entire offseason and some teammates barely even know each other. I know in my offseason workouts, I either save time at the end of practice to play a game, or I set aside an entire practice session just for fun games. I remember my team used to play wall ball at the end of practices. The whole team was playing, they got to know each other, and they just had a ton of fun playing wall ball together as a team. There were a few practices where I planned out an entire wiffle ball tournament with teams and everything. We were at an indoor facility, so there were special rules for hits and everything, but that was always so much fun. One time, me and the other assistant coaches were actually on a team, and we batted with our opposite hand, and our players tried to beat us in the tournament. Now that was fun. I'd like to hear your thoughts about this video. What is your main focus of your off-season workouts? Did you learn something new in this video that you're gonna do this year? Let me know what you think. Before we go, I wanna make sure you get your free guide. If you look down in the description area, there's a free baseball equipment sizing guide just for you. It's great for any players or parents who want to know how to find the right size bat, glove, or anything else. It covers every piece of equipment that we use in baseball, so be sure to grab yours before you go. There's also a free 2-hour practice plan I made for all coaches. It's complete with 2 practice blueprints, and it has everything you need for more efficient practices. Don't forget to grab your free guide down below. Thanks for spending some time with me today. I hope this video provided you with a few new ideas for this year's off-season workouts, and you're able to take full advantage of this off-season to become a more complete player. I'll see you next week for another edition of the Bullpen Bulletin.